From BYU Broadcasting's performance studio, this is Highway 89. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. From small but renowned venues like the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville to Britain's famous Liverpool Cathedral, Cori Connors carries her fresh voice as a songwriter to audiences worldwide. Sometimes it's Cori herself performing the songs, other times great singers in her neighborhood or in her circle of friends, and sometimes it's superstars like Chris Ledoux, Linda Ronstadt, or Tarja Turunen giving Cori platinum status as a songwriter. She's recorded 9 albums of original music filled with songs described by the LA Times as exquisite, and Cori's performance of those songs have been described by Parents' Choice International as honey-voiced. Yep, you'll see. Cori and her husband Dave are parents of 4. She describes them, in quotes, as well-adjusted, and 11 grandchildren she describes as perfect. We're happy to be sharing an hour of great Christmas music and conversation with Cori. If I could describe the feeling of her Christmas songs, I think you should close your eyes and picture that it's lightly snowing outside, very warm inside because you're by a crackling fire, maybe that sound in the background, and there should be little people, not leprechauns, little people, kids. You'll hear why. We'll talk more about it. Here is Cori Connors on vocal and guitar, Mark Robinette on the bass, performing Sleepy Little Town.
Sleepy little town, strung with Christmas lights. Wrap your love around the one who's missing you tonight. There's an empty chair at your table now. If God would grant me just one prayer, I would be there somehow. But miles and miles of winter white keep me from my home tonight. And this Christmas, we're apart, but visions of you warm my heart. At the 5 and dime that I know so well, twinkle lights keep rhythm with the Salvation Army bell. And outside City Hall, past the manger bed, families gather, children wait for the men in Christmas red. And all these miles of winter white keep me from my home tonight. And this Christmas, we're apart, I hope. Within my heart, the high school choir will sing again, oh little town of Bethlehem. I didn't know when I sang there too, I'd be missing you like I'm missing you. sleepy little town. Sleepy little town. My sleepy little town.
Cori Connors coming to you live on Highway 89, Sleepy Little Town. Name of the song, also name of an album it's from. And besides the fact that some of our listeners will have to ask their grandma and grandpa what the heck a five and dime is.
It's so true.
Cori, that's a love song to a real place, isn't it?
It is. Pleasant Hills, Pennsylvania, my hometown.
Oh, my goodness. And since you've transplanted here to Utah for years in Farmington, I believe you've been doing how many years of a Christmas concert in the community?
At least 20. It's been a lot. I'm getting up there in years.
Well, one of the aspects of your songwriting experience, one's really big and one's kind of small. The big one is people like Chris LeDoux, Linda Ronstadt that we mentioned. What do you learn when you suddenly hear someone who's kind of a big deal, famous music-wise, hearing a song that you just wrote all by yourself?
Well, it was kind of surreal the first time. I remember hearing Chris LeDoux in the parking lot of Capitol Records when I first got a copy of his first release. He released it on a couple albums. And I stood there with my friend Merlin, who sings with me, or sang with me at the time. And we opened the car doors and let the CD play, you know, in the echoing chamber of the parking garage, and, you know, try to contain a little bit of excitement. But, you know, that's kind of short-lived. It is thrilling. Of course it's thrilling, because it's an acknowledgement that you kind of know what you're doing as a songwriter. But I don't know that it's all that much more thrilling to me than singing to someone who's about to cross over on their deathbed.
Well, there's the other half of the equation, the small and the personal, because so many of these songs seem like they were written for very personal events.
And they were. Although I contend that all of our personal events carry universal, eternal themes with them. And so one of the songwriting tips I got long ago that I've embraced is that the more specific you become as a writer, the more universal the emotion becomes.
Nice. Well, set up these next few songs. Is It Snowing Tonight and Blowing Kisses?
Okay. Is It Snowing Tonight was another love song for my husband's parents. We moved from Pittsburgh, outside of Pittsburgh in West Pennsylvania, to Farmington, Utah. And we brought with us the only grandchildren of my husband's parents. And then we had two more kids after we moved out here. But I wanted them to know what it was like in the winter in Pittsburgh. And they lived on the edge of a county park, and it was just beautiful. If you know Pennsylvania, it's hilly and it's full of flora and fauna, and it's just gorgeous in the winter. My kids knew it in the summer because of summer break, but not in the winter. So I wrote this song to give them pictures of what their grandparents' home was like.
And Blowing Kisses?
Blowing Kisses was another love song for a friend who was about to Passover. She was dying of cancer. My friend Cindy Gardner was dying of cancer, and she was very sad one day when I went to visit. And I said, "Are you scared?" And she said, "You know, I'm a little scared, but that's not it." I said, "Then what is causing this?" And she said, "I'm afraid my grandkids won't know me." And so I wrote this song for her grandkids, as if she were singing it, saying, "I'll blow you kisses from where I am."
Well, let's hear these two songs. Cori Connors, we're hearing from live. Mark Robinette, bass and backing vocals here on Highway 89.
Is it snowing tonight where you are? Are the evergreens covered in white? Are you warming your love by the fire as you gather together tonight? There are presents surrounding my tree, and I'm dreaming and longing to be wishing it wasn't so far. Is it snowing tonight where you are? Is it peaceful and still in the wood? Has the doe come to feed with her fawn? Do the red birds still come for the food? You toss from the window at dawn. I am here in my miles away world, telling my boy and my girls of home in the hills of West Pennsylvania, under the same sacred star. Is it snowing tonight where you are? Wishing you weren't so far. Is it snowing tonight where you are? I cannot hold you the way that I held you, tenderly folding you close to my heart. But I can love you as I have loved you. How deeply I love you, although we're apart. Now, at the end of day, I'm only a whisper away, and I can send peace to you like no one on earth can do. I can send laughter, heavenly laughter is simply divine. And when you look up at me, where nobody else can see, I'll blow you kisses so you remember that you are mine. Beautiful morning, wake from your dreaming, rested and new. Open your window let the wind blow heavenly kisses over to you. Then at the break of day, I'm blowing kisses your way, and I can send peace to you like no one on earth can do. I can send laughter, heavenly laughter is simply divine. Then when you look up at me, where nobody else can see, I'll blow you kisses so you'll remember that you are mine. I'm blowing kisses so you'll remember that you are mine.
A pair of tunes from Cori Connors, Is It Snowing Tonight? And Blowing Kisses. Cori, we want to hear more music, but one quick question. The word simplicity comes to mind in what you're writing. You've written on your blog that before we were influenced by technology to the degree we are now, I think you like things better then. Something about that? Talk to me about
you. You mean back before technology?
Yes, talk to me about that.
Well, I like both. I'm a schizophrenic person in that regard.
I mean, you didn't drive up in a horse and buggy, but I think what I'm saying, there was something that you reached for.
There's absolutely a calmer feeling, at least when we think about simpler times. Now, I didn't live in those super simple times, and so I guess I imagine how it may have been. And I know that my grandmother, who cooked at her old wood stove, was dripping sweat most of the day, and so it can't have been all that simple. But it just seems charming to me. And
sometimes
about
it was
that.
Simple, but it was simply awful.
Yes, it was at least simply hard.
You also didn't start writing until you were a young mother in your 20s. What sparked that?
Well, actually, I wrote poetry when I was younger. Mm-hmm. I was one of the winners of the New Era Poetry Contest when I was in high school, and went to BYU on the Poetry Award and a little leadership award as well. And then when I was in my early 20s, I started having kids when I was 20, and so I got thrown into it young. I found the vehicle of my guitar and melody went well with lyrical poetry. You know, poetry and lyrics aren't very much the same, but they are from the same family. And so I just started putting them together, and it felt good. So we generally do things that feel good over and over again.
Well, here are a few more songs that feel good if you'll head over to the mic. A pair of songs that are beautifully simple and simply beautiful. This is Fall in Love and Wise Men Seek Him.
Seek Him Still. There you go, doing what you do, leaving me undone by your loveliness. You twirl around in your dancing shoes with your angel eyes and your princess dress. Just when I thought I could not love you more than I do, that's when I fall in love. I fall in love all over again with you. Sunny days, you're selling lemonade. It's sort of warm and a little too sweet. Or stormy nights when you are afraid and you crawl between us with your little cold feet. It goes against all reason, but you know that it's true. That's when I fall in love.
you. All around us, if we have the eyes to see, and sacred faces gather round us, planted on our family tree. One day you'll grow and you will know why I feel like I do. Yes, you will fall in love. You'll fall in love. Just like I fall in love. I fall in love all over again with you. They made their way through the desert sands till they came upon the Holy Land. A little town, oh little town of Bethlehem. They turned away from everything to pay their tithes to the newborn king. They were bound for a little town called Bethlehem. They knew the signs, and from their youth they searched the skies for light and truth. They covered every valley, every hill. To a gentle child in a humble place, his father's eyes, his mother's face, and why men seek him still. So I make my way to the edge of town, through the Christmas lights and the Christmas sounds, to the humble door of the tired and poor, and give to them. And in the receive, and works give life to my belief, like men of old who learned to mold their will. And through his words I'll know his face, who lived and died in a state of grace. Oh, wise men see through the desert sands or the drifting snow, where the Spirit leads, that's where I will go. As men of old who left their gold in Bethlehem.
Coming to you live from Studio 6, this is Highway 89. Wise men seek him still, before that, fall in love. Cori Connors in studio today, singer-songwriter. With her, Mark Robinette on the upright bass. Nice to hear that upright bass, that
isn't
little
whoing
sound on some of those notes. And beautiful, high, lonesome, high vocal harmonies. Cori, you have kids show up a lot in your material. There is this parental
I'm partial to them, yes.
The things that happen. And you've even won a Parents' Choice Award. So what are you thinking when you write about children? Or is it just naturally what comes to mind?
Well, it's fairly natural because it was my full-time job for a long time. And in many ways still is. I think of us really all as children, but I am really partial to the ones who have not grown into bad habits yet.
Well, tell me about One Small Boy in Heavenly Choirs, because both of these tie in with children.
Right. One Small Boy is actually based on an old couplet, 13th century couplet, that says, "Though Christ in Bethlehem 1,000 times be born, until he's born in you, your heart is still forlorn." And I thought about how many birthdays Jesus has had, and I figured it's a couple thousand. So that kind of stimulated the thought that became that song. Hmm. Heavenly Choirs was a song I wrote for my primary kids years ago when my own kids were in primary.
So these are the little kids at church.
Little kids at church. We still do it every year. We do a little neighborhood nativity, and those cute little angels stand up at the very end and sing this Heavenly Choir song. And it's really not as sweet with us singing it, but it's awfully sweet with children's voices.
Well, let's hear these. One Small Boy and Heavenly Choirs. The trouble always with children's choirs is they grow up. You're always having to get a new crew.
Is born a silent night in a little town with 1,000 angels looking down on one small boy. A simple stall, a manger bed, a brilliant star overhead, 1,000 tears his mother shed for one small boy. He is come, Emmanuel. Holy One, Emmanuel. Thousand years of Christmas days, and then again 1,000 more, until we come and we adore that one small boy. He is come, Emmanuel. Holy One, Emmanuel. Perfect life, a noble death, no greater love, no truer friend. In my heart, he's born again, one small boy. Thousand times born again, one small boy. Thank you. Had I been there, I would have sung Alleluia, Alleluia, praise to the Lord, praise to His Son, praise to the Lord, praise to His Son.
Pair of pieces from singer-songwriter Cori Connors, live on Highway 89, One Small Boy and Heavenly Choirs. Cori, you've been singing and playing with Mark Robinette this hour, and why don't you introduce him to us?
This is the magical Mark Robinette, who is as wonderfully kind as he is talented. He is an arranger, a composer, a producer, and a really fine musician. He plays every instrument known to mankind, and his heart is as big as the world, and so I feel extremely blessed to have him.
You do work with other musicians, a group of musicians, when you record and when you perform live. Mm-hmm. Has that changed your song sometimes?
Oh, absolutely. That's the beauty of different musicians and giving them freedom to create in certain parameters, and so I feel extremely blessed to have amazing musicians in my recordings and also in my concerts. And Mark is part of that. Mark assembles musicians, contracts them for really big names and sometimes little names like me. So I'm grateful to have him.
Well, speaking of instruments, it's so natural to see you holding a guitar, I almost forget it's there. But you're playing these deceptively simple little harmonies and thirds and sixths along with your voice and filling in. When did you first pick up the guitar?
I got a guitar for Christmas under the Christmas tree when I was 13. I didn't start playing it till I was 14. It was cathartic for me at that time in my life, having some difficult times in our family, and it became my therapy. You have that wood vibrating against your chest, and all the angst comes out, and all of the sorrow and the joy.
Well, let's hear a little more sorrow and joy coming through in these next few songs. The first one is called Little Did I Know, followed by a song called Broken. Cori Connors, live on Highway 89.
Thanksgiving evening, my brothers and my sisters laid on our tummies on the living room floor, pouring through the paper with crayons and markers, circling the toys we wanted that year. Little did I know then, life would bring a mouse trap, when all I really wanted was an Etch-a-Sketch. Little did I know then, so little did I know then, What I wouldn't give now to know that much. Well, the Easy Bake Oven, it was a red circle item. Santa would be groovy if he brought me that. Of course, he could always bring clothes for my Barbie. A Camelot outfit and a Guinevere hat. Little did I know then, I never would be Barbie. Heaven didn't give me the stuff for such. Little did I know then, so little did I know then, what I wouldn't give now to know that much. When I was a kid, I couldn't wait to get. Like how to do cartwheels, gather up acorns, a jar full of fireflies on a summer night, the very first snowfall, Christmas vacation, anticipation on the holy night. Little did I know then, little did I need then, just when I can reach out touch. Little did I know then, so little did I know then, what I wouldn't give now to know that much. It was made out of clay. It was shaped like a heart. And I love you was written inside. But I fell after school and the gift broke apart. So she gathered it up while I cried. And I watched as my mother pieced it together. Said she just might like it better this way. Broken clouds give us rain. Broken ground opens up and lets it in. Broken seeds growing wheat make the bread that we break and eat. So what has been broken? By the light of the moon, he kissed me goodnight, and I looked up and wished on a star. Oh, he swept me away, then he shattered my heart. So she gathered me up in her arms. She said, you won't believe this, but one day you'll see this and be thankful it happened this way. Broken clouds give us rain. Broken ground opens up and lets it in. Broken seas growing wheat make the bread that we break and eat. So much good can be grown from what has been broken. was at my side the day the angels cried and carried her home. Broken clouds gave us rain. Broken ground opened up and welcomed her in. Broken seeds growing wheat make the sacred red wheat. So much good can be grown from what has been broken. So much good has been grown from what has been broken.
Little Did I Know and Broken, a pair of songs from Cori Connors. One more here. We're switching instruments. Mark Robinette laying down the beautiful upright bass and sitting down at a pretty beautiful Steinway Grand. Cori Connors now, and You Would Have Loved This.
The winter left her blanket here this morning, a soft and gentle coverlet of white. Unfolded in the shadows of the dawn, it sparkled in the early morning light. You would have loved this. You would have loved this. This was your favorite time of day.
The mantle and ornaments are hanging on the tree,
and cradled in the windowsills a candle, a beacon in the night to call you back to me. You would have loved this. You always loved this. I know you love this time of year. And though I understand, one day again I'll see you, I long to touch your hand. Thank you. you would have loved this. You always loved this. Oh, how you loved.
Live on Highway 89, You Would Have Loved This. Cori, that song was a platinum hit in Europe, South America, in Russia, and millions of hits on YouTube recorded by a Finnish artist, Tarja Turunen. But at the heart of that song, I understand, is a very tender story from your own life.
It is. It was written after my mother-in-law was killed in a car accident. She had just dropped us off at the airport from our cottage in Michigan, and when we arrived home in Utah, we got word that she had passed away on her way back to the cottage. That was our first year in a new home, and it was just a tough time. It was just sad for all of us, and I wasn't able to sleep well, and I woke one morning very, very early, and I'm not a morning person, but she was. And I watched that sun rise and cast its beautiful pink glow over the snow, and I thought, oh, Helen would have loved this.
It's almost a little element of musical theater there to me somehow. Maybe the telling of it. Let's hear one more Christmas song before we go. We've got time for this. It's Mary Holds Him. You already have a picture in mind from hearing that title, Mary Holds Him. This might be a different Mary than you're thinking of as you hear this unfold. Cori Connors live on Highway 89.
Mary holds him. See the love light falling from her eyes around his head. Little fingers, little hands have hold the blanket tight, laid him in his bed. She's only 4 years old. She hears the story told. She knows her part. So here on this Christmas Eve, she plays like she believes with all her heart. Tiny angel, curly hair and a pair of paper wings, and the shepherd comes. Cousin Joseph, kneeling sweetly, reverently, he sings to his holy son. Story told, he knows his part. So here on this Christmas Eve, he sings what he believes with all his heart. Make us wise then, and the gifts of silver and of gold underneath the tree. These are tokens, there's a greater gift within our souls. It is this we bring. So we'll sing in harmony this song. Christmas Eve, we read and we believe with all our hearts. While Mary holds him, see the love light falling from her eyes around his head.
Mary holds him. It's been a thrill for us to bring you an episode's worth of gentle and beautiful Christmas music, beautiful songs, beautiful playing and singing. Songwriter Cori Connors joined by Mark Robinette on bass, piano, and vocals on Highway 89. You can find more of Cori's work at www.coriconnors.com. That's C-O-R-I. If you just caught part of the show and would like to hear the beginning, listen again, or share it with a friend, you can do that. All of our shows are archived online for free on-demand listening at byuradio.org/highway89. Also, follow us on Twitter at BYUH89 for live show updates and special behind-the-scenes photos and video clips. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. Our recording engineer is Mark Waite. Our student assistants are Abby Vance and Victoria Hardy. And our producer is Sam Payne. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. Thanks for listening.